Good morning, everyone. I was once on a plane, and I don't know, there was an article in the magazine in front of me, and they had a story, a Hasidic story there. And the story was from the famous story of Zusha, that when he was on his deathbed, he was crying. A student said, "Why are you crying?" He said, "Because I'm going to meet my Maker." So they said, "What are you afraid of? You've lived a righteous life." He said, "I do not fear that God will ask me, why weren't you as great as Abraham? Because I could answer that question. I wasn't created to be as great as Abraham. I didn't have his potential. Why weren't you as great as Moses? I'm not worried about that question. If God says, why weren't you as great as Maimonides? I don't have the mind of Maimonides." He says, "The one question I fear when I meet my Creator is when God says, Zusha, why weren't you Zusha?" Every person is asked to be themselves to their fullest potential. The name of the new book we're starting, the third book of the Torah, is called, in English they call it Leviticus, because it's about the Levites and the sacrifices. But the Hebrew name is Vayikra. Vayikra means, "and he called." And God is calling Moshe. But our rabbis say that it represents the fact that every human being is called by God for a purpose. As a matter of fact, there's a custom to start learning with children when they go to yeshiva at 3 years old, not Bereshis, but Vayikra. Because the first message to a child is, you are put here for a purpose. You may be very small, and that's why there's a little aleph in Vayikra representing the little children. But you were put in this world for a purpose, and your mission is to hear and listen to what your calling is. But the key to finding your calling is that you have to be willing to make sacrifices. Sometimes we know what our calling is, but we don't pick up the phone. We don't answer God's call. Why? It's too difficult. It's too challenging. But the key to finding your calling in life is you have to be willing to make the sacrifices it entails. Because in life, nothing worthwhile is accomplished without sacrifice. Anything you want to do in life requires sacrifice. Having children and raising children requires sacrifice. Going into a marriage, a relationship requires sacrifice. Getting a good job, a career. The greater the career is, the greater the sacrifice. If you want to be a great athlete, you have to sacrifice. There's nothing worthwhile. If you look at everything in life, the proportion of its worthiness is proportionate to how much sacrifice it entails. So if you avoid sacrifice, you're going to avoid any accomplishments or any greatness. So the Torah says, Vayikra, you have to hear your calling. But you have to know that you have to be prepared to make sacrifices. And then the Torah says three rules about sacrifices. You're not allowed to use honey. You're not allowed to use yeast. And you must always have salt. Why? Honey is sweetness, but it's superficial sweetness. God says, you have enough sweetness inside of you. You don't have to have superficial sweetness. Yeast is an inflation of your ego, right? It represents haughtiness. You don't have to make yourself bigger than you are and act haughty and inflate your self-value. Just be yourself. And that's why you have to use salt, because salt draws out the flavor of the food. And the idea of the salt with every sacrifice is, be prepared to make sacrifices, offerings to God, and just bring out your own goodness, your own potential that God put within you, your own latent talents and abilities. And that's all God wants every person to be. As Zusha said, God only asks Zusha, why weren't you Zusha? It's a story told about a water carrier who used to carry water up to the palace every day. He had a pole with two buckets. One bucket had a crack in it. And by the time he got up to the palace to deliver the water, one bucket was full, one was half empty. He felt bad that half the water was falling out. So one day the king said, "Don't feel bad, let me show you something." He said, "Look at the two sides of the path. The side with the full bucket, with no crack in the bucket, there was nothing growing there. But the side with the broken pot, with the crack, there were beautiful flowers growing all along the path because the water was dripping out and watering the flowers." So he says, you see, even your broken pot serves a purpose. Sometimes we feel we're cracked, we're broken, we have a deficiency. But God made us exactly the way we are because everything about us is perfect in God's eyes and was made for a purpose as long as we're willing to utilize it to the best of our abilities.